Hello everyone, this is Chen Gong. This video will be recorded in dual language in both Chinese and English. I hope this can benefit the most audience with different backgrounds. Starting from this video, I'm going to share with you something I know pretty well. I've been doing QMMM since my bachelor thesis. At the very beginning, I used Gaussian ONIOM. During my master in Belfast, I moved on to QMMM in Chemshell with Orcam. I have also tested several other QMMM software such as Sender in Ember, Orca native QMMM, and also TerraCam, which can do DFT on GPU. After hours and hours of testing software and reading papers, I hope my practical experience will be helpful for you. So QMMM, is this all you are asking for? A sigmatropic reaction just happened. If at the moment the only thing you know about QMMM is that QMMM got the Nobel Prize in 2013, then in the coming 10 minutes, I will introduce you to different flavors of QMMM, from the simplest implementation to the complete long-range electrostatic description with explicit entropy calculation. By the way, the Nobel Prize in Chemistry in 2013 was actually awarded for the development of multi-scale models for complex chemical systems. The keyword is multi-scale models. This means as long as you are using two different time or space scale, you are doing multi-scale model. If you do all-atom MD and coarse-grain MD, yes, you are doing multi-scale modeling. If you run MD simulation and also build a Markov model based on the MD result, yes, you are also doing multi-scale modeling. I will also mention some senior researchers who prefer this or that flavor. Their flavors are quite conserved, so if you keep reading those papers for a while, you will realize that the moment you see the name, you already know pretty much all the method in the paper. The first implementation is QM cluster. To be honest, this is not exactly QMMM. There's no MM at all. Maybe there is an implicit solvent. The QM cluster is becoming rare these days. But after many years of doing QM cluster, Fahami Himo is still publishing great papers using Gaussian 09 doing QM cluster. Let's have a look at the latest one. This is his latest paper in 2021. Let's jump to the method part. Optimization during B3 leap 631G star star. The optimized structure was used for further single point calculation on the B3 leap 6311 star star plus and implicit solvent. So why don't you use implicit solvent during the optimization? Maybe he developed this workflow when Gaussian did not support first-order gradient many years ago. If we move one step forward, we will get QMMM mechanical embedding using Gaussian ONIOM. At least this is a real QMMM implementation. The interaction between a QM atom and a MM atom was described as the original MM force field. The QM allows you to break or form a chemical bond, and the MM force field allows you to model thousands of atoms, but the QM calculation is actually running in vacuum. As the QM-MM interaction is purely MM, there's no polarization from MM to QM region, and this is why this implementation is called mechanical embedding. Because the MM atom can only apply mechanical force on the nuclear. Gaussian ONIOM is also rare on high-impact factor journals nowadays. I also can't really name anyone who favor QMMM Gaussian ONIOM. There are several reasons for that. First of all, no optimization in electronic embedding. Although Gaussian provided this option, but as far as I know, this functionality is very badly reviewed. Gaussian manual also suggests you to optimize under mechanical embedding. There's no native tool to convert MM parameter to a Gaussian input. So many years after Gaussian implemented QMMM, they still haven't provided a native tool to convert Ember parameter top or charm PSF or GrowMax top to Gaussian input, this actually creates a lot of nasty work in preparing input and a lot of chances to make mistakes. As far as I know, you can either prepare ONIOM input from GView, but that means you are restricted to Ember FF99SB, which comes with Gaussian, or use the VMD plugin called MoUp. But you will run into some sort of missing parameter from time to time. Is the electronic embedding really that important? Why do so many senior QMM researchers constantly criticize Gaussian ONIOM for the lack of polarization? If you have some experience with MD simulation, you probably have some impression of PME. The van der Waal can be cut off, but for the electrostatic, you cannot simply cut it off at 1 nanometer. You have to use PME to calculate the long-range electrostatic interaction. There's no doubt that either or both the short-range or long-range electrostatic interaction can affect QMMM. When doing QMM, you can never run away from the question of how to describe the QMM interaction. If you don't want to let the QM calculation nakedly happen under vacuum, electronic embedding is your option. As far as I know, Chemshell is the only option. Although you can also do mechanical embedding in Chemshell, but as electronic embedding is technically more correct, all the Chemshell users are actually using electronic embedding. When I decided to move to Chemshell, that was indeed because of the electronic embedding. There are many people who prefer Chemshell QMMM. I'm only going to list three of them: Adrian Mulholland in Bristol, Samson Sheikh in Israel, and Walter Thiel from Germany. The optimization code DLFind was actually developed by Walter Thiel. Every one of them has published great papers on high impact factor journals using Chemshell. Except Walter Thiel, others are still active in the field of QMMM. Chemshell can do electronic embedding, this is great, but it also has some clear disadvantage compared to Gaussian. Chemshell is using TCL, this means a long learning curve. Chemshell needs an external QM software. This means you have to learn at least another QM software such as Orca. There's no native GUI for Chemshell. This means you have to learn VMD or any other alternative you prefer. Chemshell cannot do analytic second derivative, only numerical second derivative. This really limits the tricks you can do during optimization. Although it is not particularly user-friendly, I have managed to publish a PCCP with Chemshell and Orca. Except for those senior researchers I mentioned, I also found this recent paper from Frank Nies during my preparation of the video. Frank Nies is actually doing QMM using Chemshell, but not the Orca native QMM implementation. This indicates that there is still some sort of limitation in Orca's native QMM. From my testing, the major limitation is actually the coordinate. Orca QMM can only use Cartesian coordinates when you have a system as large as a protein. And the manual also suggests using nudge elastic bound to do a TS search. Without the redundant coordinates, this QMM implementation is very useful for the protein system. Maybe none of the above QMM can meet your expectation. Where was the fancy MD at the start of the video? I have to admit that that was actually a MD simulation running with Orca under vacuum. 100 frames were chosen for the movie. The final frame was aligned to the crystal structure. Firstly, this was not a QMM MD. Secondly, that was still far from getting a statistically significant free energy. I guess this is what most people thought about QMM, and it is also what I thought about QMM at the very beginning, to run some MD with QMM. This is actually a separate field, and most of the people in the field would use the word QMMMD. The word QMMMD immediately tells you that this is a real free energy. This is not the fake free energy from thermal correction. We would also start from the simplest. There is this functionality in Ember tool which allows you to play with QMMMD. I highly recommend this QMMMD implementation if you just want to experience the QMMMD. The whole Ember tool is free. The semi-empirical QM method does not ask for too many resources. You can get the PME of alanine dipeptide before launch. It can also do electronic embedding. People has published well with Sander, although the barrier is 50 kcal per mole. Maybe you also feel something wrong with 50 kcal per mole. There is also some imperfection in Sander QMMMD. When you run QMMMD in Sander, if you want to use periodic boundary condition, you have to use the mechanical embedding, because the QM calculation here cannot run with PBC. If you want to use electronic embedding, if you want to let the MM atom polarize the QM region, a cutoff is needed. A more common way to do this is to use fixed boundary condition and set a cutoff large enough so that all the MM atoms are always inside the cutoff. If there is an MM atom that can move in and out of the cutoff, unfortunately, this will cause potential energy discontinuous. If you have looked through Mark's tutorial, you will know that there is one cutoff for the moving atom, and the atoms outside this cutoff cannot move. There is also another cutoff where the atom outside was simply thrown away. The second cutoff actually cut some of the protein. In the last section, as I promised, there are some ways to fully describe the long-range electrostatic just as PME, and also do free energy explicitly. There are several options. There's a special customized version of QChem with Ember developed by a group of people from YHU. There's a special version of CP2K and GrowMax, but that requires you to build CP2K from the source code and build GrowMax on top of that. There is a native named Orca interface that can do QMMMD, but they offer five different options to treat long-range electrostatic interaction. Unfortunately, I have used none of this QMMMD software. The reason is actually simply because of the resources. Let me do an estimation here. Assume each MD step needs 5 minutes. If the plan is to run 100 picosecond of NVT plus 100 picosecond of NPT equilibrium and 200 picosecond of production MD. In the QM region, you cannot do constraint, so you need 1 femtosecond time step. So 400 picosecond would takes you 5 times 400 times 1000. That would be 200,000 minutes. That is 33,333 hours, and that is 1,388 days, and that is 4 years. None of the testing of debugging has been taken into account. We also haven't considered multiple windows for umbrella sampling. We also haven't considered error analysis. If you are lucky enough to limit each step to 5 seconds, 400 picosecond will still cost you 23 days. We finally reached the edge of the computational resources, but you shouldn't be afraid to dream bigger. This paper used named Orca QMMMD to study the covalently bonded inhibitor. They used on-chemical free energy calculation and the QMMMD to study the full inhibition process. This paper used CP2K QMMMD to study the proton transport. The result is consistent between two mutations. Wu Ruibo has used the QChem Ember QMMMD to study the selectivity. If you find this video helpful, please give me a thumb up. I will explain those QMMM implementation in detail in the coming video. This is Chen Gong. See you next time.